Teacher Raymond, and this time Anna is one of the karate teachers as well. So we just got to know because my music therapy clinic in a community center and in a meeting room, and karate big karate class is held in a big hall. Just we have very thin walls between us, doing very different things. Play music in one side and other side, and the karate people just ha ha. We never thought we can cooperate something. We just talk hello and goodbye and for long years. But after long years, Raymond and I just met in a kind of meeting in a community center. And I forgot the whole name, but we just talk about maybe we can just play something together. And on that night after the meeting, we just tried some kata and a piano and improvising, and that was very exciting. We were so excited. We should do it somewhere. And that's why in 2011, in the first concert, we performed this piece. Actually, we performed the same kata. It's called gankaku. But when we practice together, even though the kata is the same, because different performer, different practitioner, it looks so different. And then I thought maybe I shouldn't play the totally same music as last time. And I totally played a different music. It might be interesting. I just show you the difference. There are two traditional Japanese scales. So one is in melody and one is yang melody. And it originally came from China. But for example, so it sounds very Japanese, doesn't it? Yeah. Yeah, it's like an E melody and another Japanese melody. Actually, it's called pentatonic as well in a lot of countries. So we have two different yeah melodies, a bit soft, and then E melody is very sharp, can be sharp. And then I use the E melody for the male practitioner Raymond, and I use mainly, I played a little bit yeah E melody as well, but mainly very gentle. This melody as well, and this is my feel from her performance. Yeah, a little bit of trivia. And would you talk about karate then?
Hello everyone, thank you Izumi for this opportunity. I think she already said everything I wanted to say, so just a little bit of background. There's three aspects of karate practice we do. There's a kion, which is a repetition of basic techniques. We do kumite, which is sparring, and then kata, which is the organized sequence of movements. Kata is probably considered the heart of karate because it's not just about a sequence of movements, but it's about making an expression of the human body, and it's also the training of mindfulness, so it's almost like the hardest part of making it. And when you become a black belt, or when you're almost a black belt, usually a sensei gives you a dedicated kata, because it's considered that you should train and practice this single kata for the whole of your life to perfect this art. So it's also called the tukui kata, so your favorite kata, so the young kata is my favorite kata. And it roughly translates to train on the rock, so lots of long lines, and it's very elegant, and yeah, I like it very much. And it's thank you to Izumi for this opportunity, and it gives me a new insight into this, the character of Gunko. Thank you very much.
Okay, so the next one is a church choir. So it's so beautiful, every single person has a beautiful voice, and I was very impressed in the rehearsal. So please enjoy.